Yeah, good evening, panel members and ladies and gentlemen. First of all, before I start, I must say, you know, it's a great disadvantage to have the lectures in the end of the day. One is the audience numbers reduces drastically, and secondly, you find there are lots of repetitions and what all things have been already covered up in the morning. So bear with me in case you find repetition. But this is a very interesting topic for me, and which is defense industry complex concept to reality. And like the word complex, it is actually a complex problem. But we'll see how we can try to find out the solution. And here I feel I will be able to contribute because there are two parts of this first liner I belong to. I'm an ex-defense officer and served for 25 years, so I understand the defense requirements very clearly. I was in an R&D organization, and now I am part of the corporate, so I understand what are the nuances on this side, and maybe I would be able to give some suggestions how to marry them together. I would be covering my presentation under the headings as given. I feel this whole problem needs to be understood in a holistic manner. Here, what is happening since morning when I have been hearing, you know, people are giving suggestions, but nobody is giving a total global picture. This whole problem has to be understood in a global manner. I feel there are very clear-cut boundaries which have been created where, you know, I feel this is my part of work, I have done it, now it's your botheration, you please take on. This will not work till the time the whole system becomes a common problem for all the stakeholders who get involved. This is what is my view. Anyway, I would be covering more on this, but my only, what I have got inferred by today's this thing is that till the time we understand the problem, 50% of the problem gets solved. And I feel we have already reached that juncture where we know what is the problem. And it's like a patient going to a doctor, if you have a sound hearing, I feel 50% problem gets resolved, the rest medication will take care. We are also at that stage where I am very positive, 50% of the thing is already resolved on this issue, and we will be able to find out a solution on this. Now, before I move ahead, you know, I would like to give a coverage of, you know, we must, in the whole defense systems, there is an emerging change scenario. Like a previous panel, we had discussions on R&D. Now, I have been part of R&D, you know, what we are doing R&D here is only to cover up, cope up to a stage where other countries have already built up the systems. That is not R&D. In my definition, R&D is something new, some innovative, which others have not done. So there is a drastic difference. Now what is happening is by the time we catch up and the emerging changing scenario, and we are only trying to catch up with some global companies or who are available, by the time you catch up, the war scenario changes. Like what Director R&D Bell covered up, from platform centric to network centric, it is every day evolving. So when we are looking for R&D, we should not look into only by trying to catch up what others are doing. Now here, this is what, when I'm saying evolving every day, you know, on the defense services, the scenario is changing, paradigm shift is changing. And also we need to understand, you know, whatever is applicable in the defense forces in other countries may not be directly applicable to us. So we cannot build up a system which is not acceptable to the defense forces. So there is an understanding, very close understanding required with the defense forces and the industry and the other DPSUs who are creating the systems. Now here, what I'm trying to highlight is, now each node in a war scenario is getting connected. Type of information which is being passed on is huge. So systems have to be built up which are state of the art. See, what is happening is, even after lots of efforts, after 4 or 5 years, when we produce a system, we say R&D, production, etc., by the time we give a system to our users, to defense forces, we realize other countries have already moved ahead. So it's a cat and rat race which is happening, which I feel we need to look into a more holistic way. Now, if you ask me, all these technologies which are involved in various defense systems are very clear-cut defined. And I'm telling you, I was surprised. I feel in India, these, I have made blocks. Why? Because all these technologies are available in India. But there is nobody who is binding these blocks together to build up a figure what I have made. I am telling you, it is not that a grave a problem. Problem is only we need to look into and stitch together all these things together. I feel that will give the real solution on this. I am not going into the details of the technologies, but they are very clear cut. And I feel all these technologies are available in a different frame structure. Only you connect up these dots to the type of systems what you need to build up. Now, like I put up a point, changing war scenario. Now there are also technologies are evolving every day. I am telling you what previous slide I showed are the technologies what we are talking of, and countries ahead of us are already working on the futuristic technologies. So there is a gap. And there is no point working on something where, you know, we are only trying to catch up. So we need to, when we are planning our things, we also have to plan not what is our existing requirements, what is going to be our futuristic requirements. Now, this slide has already been amply covered, and I feel this is a drive for private companies to look into. There's a huge business which is going to come in, but how to tap this business? There is no single agency who can take on this type of business and meet the requirements of the defense services of India. Now, I would like to cover up some. Where do we stand? You know, some of the points have already been covered on this. Now, only point what I'm trying to say is global OEMs sharing their sensitive and strategic technology is a fallacy. I have worked for 25 years, discussed with many countries, they will not give. Because naturally, it's not possible. But I am saying, if you do joint ventures, if you work together, we just need some part, some base. Thereafter, how to build it up, we have done it. During my naval tenure, I did a joint development, many projects, but you know, with Russians also, we developed on combat management systems, on certain modules. And we realized, you know, once we understood the whole thing, it is not that difficult. We have, but only thing is base has to be created, and it is possible to create that base. Now, as of now, what my point is, we are all scattered. There are things are available. We need a group or somebody to think on how to collect those dots, and those dots collecting together can produce wonders for us. Second slide, like, you know, FDI, we said 49%. I was surprised to see the figures. Then, you know, after FDI, and we have received offset only worth 15.3 million, which is not much. Now, defense manufacturing requires infrastructure. And if we are starting now, and if we don't think in a big way, we are always going to be in catching race. And here, I believe, like, we have been discussing MSMEs or bigger companies can be the strategic partners whose hand has to be held by the government to take it as a common project. Like we have been saying, you know, there is only one buyer, there is only one sellers, also very limited numbers. So there has to be a partnership model which needs to be worked upon. Now, these are all discussed, all these theories are already available and we have been discussing in the morning. But like what Dr. Rahul Chaudhary said, now is the time has come to walk the talk. And I feel we should never prepare ourselves that, okay, let me first get 100% prepared, keep on doing planning, and then I'll do. Even if you are 50% prepared, 60% prepared, it is a time to plunge. And that plunge will only happen once government and all these organizations, they come together and we have faith on each other and saying that, okay, even if something is not available, they can be done. Now here I would like to bring to your perspective is, this is my Bharat Forge, this thing. If you see the other companies, I'm saying there is a baseline already available. We are the best company in the metallurgical as of now. There's so much of exports there. You see all foreign companies which are given on the right side, Bofors and other things. Once upon a time, they were also on the same baseline. If they can do it, we can do it. This is what I'm saying. And we don't have to reinvent the wheel. Things are already available. Only thing is, have faith. Follow the same model and structure which is followed globally, it will happen. Now these are the systems. Now here, without waiting for anything, Bharat Forge is getting into all these things on these type of systems on which we are working on. Now we have also done JVs with very major companies with this strategic thinking in our mind. And I'm telling you, we are quite hopeful that these things will happen. And only thing is, it should happen on a faster pace. We are only looking forward to greater support from the government, greater support from the DRDOs, PSUs. Now this is the model what I have been proposing here. Now you see, I have made four blocks. Like in the, since morning we have been discussing, everybody is talking about only about his part, yellow part, government, armed forces. We have been saying, okay, you know, their requirements have been drastic, which I totally agree. We have also, because there is no awareness. Till the time these all four blocks do not actually form a circle and I crisscross, it means government also has a bid in R&D, government also has a bid in industry, similar vice versa. I cannot, no block can look itself in an isolation. Now this is the same. I feel by virtue of my experience that R&D or industry or government or cannot be looked into isolation. We all have to work together from the very start of the project. That's why this pyramid has been made, and it's highly possible. Only how to make it integrate all these things together, that's what thought process has to go on. And it is not possible from bottom to top. It is top to bottom, where the government policies have to work in a very stringent way to ensure that all these blocks, small blocks, are united together.
So we'll have to wrap it up now.
Yeah, okay. Now, I will, based on whatever we have spoken of, so I am also proposing certain actionable strategies which should be adopted, which we can deliberate upon. I'm saying, first of all, for connecting these blocks, it has to be a top-down approach. Let's have a national agency, which I'm told that something is happening, but that happening has to happen fast. Then only we'll be able to produce the system in much better. Also, there should be a policy only for, see, as of now in private sectors, things are given only for the manufacturing. I'm saying, no, please give us the whole system, we can deliver. And that's only one moment you put on responsibility, then only people deliver. It's a human factor. If you don't put on the responsibility, nobody works. If you give me less responsibility, I'll only be able to use only 50% of my capability. I don't want that. Also, like JVs, I'm saying it's a possibility. And also participation of multitudes of industries. Like morning we spoke of strategic partnership. That is the way out. Where government, we know these systems are not going to come out in one day or two. And maybe like buyers are only government. Tomorrow the systems may get obsolete because of one or other reasons. That's why smaller industries are not able to plunge in a bigger way. Moment you give them some assurance that it is going to happen, don't worry, whatever happens, I will buy back. I feel that is the model what should be looked into. Similarly, like morning we discussed capability prioritized. What is essential? We cannot do everything one day, but services needs, war is happening every day. Please understand. And naturally, we can't tell user, okay, I'm doing R&D, I'll take 5 years, I'll give you an indigenous product, but you fight your war after 5 years. Not possible. This is where the gaps. So we need to prioritize what I can do based on my capability. I'm telling you, if you move around in India, you'll find various companies have got very specific capabilities. They can easily build on. But even if you combine those capabilities, you might not be able to build on 100% of the system what defense forces are asking. But even if we are able to 60, take in 40. To plunge so that they are also happy, and this is how the system flows on. That's all, and only I can say that the rise of domestic defense industry would only enable India to reduce its arms supplies, what we have been discussing in the morning, and we, Kalyani Group, are committed to contribute towards the same, and we are really going big strides to make it happen. Thank you very much.